Hi, it's Dr. Lori, and I'm back with more real bargains. Thanks so much for sharing the videos. These are the, of course, real bargains that people like you, or maybe it's you, have been finding at the thrift stores, yard sales, flea markets, antique malls, all over. I'm going to share them with you. Everybody's given me permission to retell their great stories, and here's the first great story we've got. I was on a video call with a husband and wife thrifting team. And you know, you all know me, you know I'm going to tell you what to do. Here's what I've been telling everybody. You really got to find the artwork. The artwork, most people can't identify it. I can help you identify it. Buy it low and sell it high. The margins are great for artwork. This particular piece is a painting, and here's an example. This piece was bought at a thrift store for $1. $1. That's it. And this husband and wife team said, well, we really liked it. We liked the colors, the landscape. It was signed. And the back was even signed. And it was even titled, which is called inscribed. But it was even titled on the back, Taos Valley, New Mexico, right near Santa Fe. Wonderful Taos, the great artist colony that all of you know. So they looked at it, didn't really know who the artist was. But in fact, they understood from the signature that it was Howard Sheetler. Howard Sheetler painted this painting in 1937. 1937 marked right on it. It's dated, it's titled, it's signed. These are big deals when you're looking at art. It really helps the potential buyer to feel confident in these particular pieces in what you're trying to sell. So they did a little bit of searching, talked to me on a video call, and sold this piece for $21,000 on a $1 investment. $21,000. Sold it at auction in a place where Sheetler was relatively well known, got a buyer, and there you go. That's a real bargain. This next real bargain comes from a yard sale. And you know yard sales, you know, you're walking around. This particular person I met because she sent in a photograph to my online, to the website at drlorieb.com. So she sent this in and she said, you know, I got a haul at this particular yard sale, Dr. Lori, got a lot of stuff. And one of the things that I got here, this particular piece is kind of big. And what was interesting about that was, while it was kind of big for her to actually carry out of the yard sale, it was a good thing that she put in the physical energy to carry it out of the yard sale. This particular piece, again, is a ceramic piece, and you have to be careful when you're moving ceramics, right? You really shouldn't have a million things in your hands when you're moving ceramics because, you know, you could actually drop it, you could crack it, you could actually hit your watch up against it. They're relatively fragile, you know, unlike other things like furniture and even paintings, which aren't as fragile as ceramics. So she's at the yard sale, she's walking around, she's got some stuff, she's making a haul, as she says. And she basically looks at this piece and she sends me a picture and she says, I really want an online appraisal, Dr. Lori. I said, okay. So I do the online appraisal and she says, I can't believe this. The only reason why I bought it was because it was big and because it was marked. The mark is really clear. You can see the mark. It's a work by an artist named Charles Catou, is a Belgian artist working for a firm called Bach Frères, or the Bach brothers in, of course, French. And this Belgian piece is a blue vase with a deer on it, a stag on it, in fact. Dates from 1925. I identified it for her, told her that the materials was, of course, ceramic with enamel. Dates to 1925. What's it worth for her? $15 yard sale investment? Now I know what you're thinking. You're all thinking, oh, $15 at the yard sale. I wouldn't pay $15 at the yard sale. That's too much. Well, it wasn't too much for this particular piece. $15 investment at that yard sale with the rest of the stuff that she got, it's worth $2,500. For 15 bucks, this individual 14-inch high vase, it's like a hearth vase, pretty tall for a vase, not a table vase really, worth $2,500. And you want to think about size when you're looking at these pieces. It was in good condition and she got a real bargain. This next real bargain comes from a video call. So I met these two people who actually found these lamps during a video call, and I've had video calls with them before, and they go around and they shop at all different places, thrift stores, yard sales, estate sales. They find a lot of great stuff. And a lot of people like to, of course, resell lamps. They like to rewire them. They like to, of course, highlight them with different shades. And they really like these particular mid-century period lamps. There's a big market for them. However, you have to know what's accurate because the lamp folks are very, very specific and they're very, very particular about what they have. So they have to make sure that the identification is right. And a lot of times the identification is not right. So stay right here with me and I'll teach you what the expert knows. Having said that, these particular real bargain examples are two what are called mushroom lamps. They're made in Germany by a firm called Peel and Putzler. And Peel and Putzler are very well known. How did I help them identify these particular lamps? Well, by the cord. Actually, by the plug and the cord on them. The cord is still the original cord. If you have the original cord and it works, wow, that's wonderful. If you have to rewire it, it's not terrible, but this particular real bargain didn't need a rewiring at all. So they're mushroom lamps. Look at them. They look like mushrooms. And this particular form, you know immediately, if you know anything about art and design, that they have to date to the 1965 to 1975 era. That time period, of course, of what we call the Age of Aquarius, moving out of the era of the late 1960s and into the 1970s, where natural forms are really popular. And forms that are organic or curved are really popular, like these particular lamps. They're in beautiful condition. It's amazing the condition that they're in. And when they're in good condition, of course, you can command more when you're trying to sell them. So when you're trying to sell them, you want to make sure that you are identifying those condition elements and talking about the materials. Always talk about the materials in your listings if you're trying to sell these pieces. This particular real bargain was found, of course, at a Goodwill thrift store. And all the thrift stores have great stuff, that Salvation Army, the Goodwill, Care and Share thrift stores, whatever it is, as do the estate sales and yard sales and other places, antique malls and those antique booths that people set up too. This thrift store price tag was $6.99 for the lamps. What are they worth? $475 each. For the mid-century, late 1960s German mushroom lamps. They're of a type, they're of a style, and wow, are they a real bargain. This next real bargains comes from a video call, and it'll teach you something about being nice to people. I always say, you know what, be nice to people. It's not that difficult, it'll cost you nothing, be nice to people. You know, not everybody's nice to me, but most people are nice to me, and I think that it doesn't take a lot for you to be nice. So basically, this guy was on a video call with me. He said, oh, Dr. Lori, you've got a lot of stuff, and this particular piece I wanted you to look at because somebody gave it to me. I said, really? I said, why did they give it to you? He said, well, I live next door to an elderly woman, and I used to help her out. My wife and I live next door, so, you know, if she needed help bringing in the groceries or doing a chore around the house, I'd go over and help. So, you know, she's a nice lady, and I didn't mind, and I had extra time to help out, and it was great. If you can do that, and you can afford to do that, and you have the time and the energy, great. It's wonderful to help out. You know, I have great neighbors. You know, they help me out, too. So, basically, this guy says to me, my client says to me on the video call, you know, I was helping her out, and one day I get a knock on the door, and it's a guy, and he's holding this painting. And he, you know, I invite him in, and he said, I'm Richard Obenchain, and my mother lives next door. Well, if you don't know who Richard Obenchain is, he is a pretty famous artist, and he, in fact, is born in 1944, and this particular artwork that he had under his arm that he brought into my client is a work from the late 1900s. And this particular piece is oil on canvas in his traditional and characteristic style, his mature style, I would call it. What does that mean? That means if you have a work of art and it's by a particular artist, you want that work of art to look like the works of art that he's known for. It's called a mature style. It's the style that everybody knows this artist for once he hits his mature period, right? Characteristic of the landscapes that he would actually paint, and this particular piece in the medium oil on canvas that he usually uses. Okay, so Richard Obenchain is at the door, and his wife is all excited because she knows who he is, and he's like, oh my gosh, he's in my house, and it was really funny the way they told the story. So he comes in with the painting, and it's framed, puts it down, and says, I want to thank you for helping my mother. You've been a help to my mother, and I want you to have this painting. So my client gets this painting for free, And what's it worth with the frame? $2,500. And that's a real bargain. And it's a wonderful, real, touch your heart kind of story too. Because just for helping a neighbor, he got something great. That's a real bargain. This next real bargain comes from another video call. And you know I do these video calls, and you know that people can send in objects, pictures of objects to me all the time. I digress, I almost said sent in objects. Do not send me an object, I will not accept an object. Don't send me anything. But this particular piece is one from a video call, and yes, you can of course have a video call, and yes, you can send in pictures too. And it measures 24 by 17. So it's kind of like pretty big, and it's oval, so oval in shape, right? Remember when you had to learn all the shapes, you know, oval, this, that. I remember when you were a little kid, you had to learn all the shapes, and then they throw in like trapezoid, and you'd be like, well, that's a funny shape, you know? Anyway, so it's an oval shape, and this particular piece is circa the mid-1900s to the late-1900s. So that's like 1950 to 1975, that neck of the woods. So this particular piece is marquetry. You've probably heard that word, marquetry. Marquetry, where they put all the little tiny pieces of wood, they carve them out individually, and they put them together, sort of like a puzzle. The thing about marquetry is, the more or the larger number of different types of wood, the more interesting the actual piece is. So there are a lot of these that are mass produced. There are a lot of these that are produced by hand, places like Italy. And then of course, a lot of the Asian countries started to make them too. But they actually, marquetry work actually starts in the Mediterranean, particularly in Italy. And you know, my family history is of course Italian, and they were in fact stonemasons who used to put together these different types of stones in a particular style that's not unlike wooden marquetry. But this particular piece is wooden marquetry, and this particular piece was purchased at an antiques mall booth. So it's an antique mall, there's a lot of different booths, there's a lot of different sellers and antique dealers who are able to offer all different types of wares, you know, everything from soup to nuts. So my client goes in and she says, you know, I like to do repurposing and I like to resell, and I kind of am interested in upcycling. You've heard about upcycling and repurposing. You have to know when it's a good idea to repurpose an antique or a vintage item, but sometimes you can make a lot of money if you can make something better. And a lot of you are talented and can actually do that. A lot of repurposers who follow me, in fact, will say that to me. They'll go, Dr. Lori, I want to know if this is okay for me to refinish. You know, do I have a Chippendale side table that I shouldn't refinish before I go painting it over with chalk paint and using my talents? And I tell people about that. This is what she was looking for, my client was looking for, when she found this. And she said, well, I knew I couldn't repurpose or upcycle this, but I really wanted it because it was beautiful. And it's about educating your eyes. It's about looking at these pieces and starting to recognize what's a quality piece. And that's what I want you to understand. Because yeah, a lot of these are actually reproduced and mass produced, and some of those are not worth all that much at all. But again, you have to be able to tell that from that. So that's the old-fashioned, you know, compare and contrast. You want to look at it and say, I'm going to compare it to this. But what you have to be able to do is know, in fact, what the quality is and recognize the quality. So all these people online who are doing all of this, oh, it looks like this, and I have this, and then I search for it, and it looks like this, and they're not right because they aren't able to do the compare and contrast. You need to know certain things. What do you need to know? You need to know about condition. You need to learn about the materials. You have to understand about time period and how they work in certain time periods. All this stuff is what I'm going to teach you. And once you learn it, you're going to be able to walk into any environment and you're going to go right to the quality objects. You're going to go right to the money objects. And that's what I want you to be able to do, whether you're a buyer or whether you're a seller, because it's necessary for you to be able to identify that no matter which side of the table you're on. Are you buying? You want to buy quality. Are you selling? You want to recognize quality. This particular piece was at the antiques mall. And again, she was looking for something totally different when this jumped out at her. And that happens, you know, you're looking for stuff and you're saying to yourself, well, you know, I really wasn't looking for this, but it's right here. I might have to have it. You know, that happens. You know, that happens when you're thrifting. You know, that happens when you're at a yard sale. Didn't expect to get a sterling silver tray, but wow, it's sitting here for 15 bucks. I'm going to buy the sterling silver tray. So this becomes relatively important. On this video call, this woman actually in the antique mall bought this particular piece for $16. So it was 16 bucks. 24, so 2 feet by 17 inches for $16, right? So like a dollar an inch, right, across. And this particular piece worth $600. Marquetry can be very valuable, and this particular piece, because of the intricacies of the different types of wood and all of the different actual inset puzzle pieces, if you will, wonderful example. She hangs it on the wall. I told her, make sure that you hang it with two hooks. Don't hang it on a nail. Don't hang it on a screw because it could fall because it's relatively heavy. And then she said, well, maybe I won't hang it on the wall. Maybe I'll just lean it up and use a table easel. So maybe that's what she'll do. Either way, it's going to look good in her house. This next real bargain is also from a video call, and it was really funny because the woman who bought this particular piece bought it for $10 at an auction. She resells on eBay and Etsy and Poshmark and Ruby Lane and all Cherish and all of these places, First Dibs. And basically what she did was she, in fact, purchased this particular piece at an auction, and she purchased it because she felt bad for it. So she's sitting at the auction and she's feeling bad because this lacquer box with the little woman, with the woman on it, is not getting any attention from the auction bidders. Nobody wants the little box. No one cares that it's red lacquer inside and black lacquer outside. No one cares that it's hand painted. And in fact, she says, I just liked it. I felt bad that nobody wanted it. So for $10, my client buys it, right? And I said, well, it's beautiful. I said, it tells a Russian folk tale. She said, well, I did see your other videos about different types of boxes and different types of lacquer and ceramic and sevres and Russian and all different kinds of boxes and trinkets. And wow, you know what? I just thought maybe I should buy this particular one. So as I'm doing the video call, I say to her, well, you notice that it's signed. She said, where is it signed? I said, it's signed right there, right on the front, right at the lower center. And there it was in Cyrillic. It was signed in the Russian language. Well, she didn't recognize that. So I showed her that, and I told her the folk tale. And this particular piece was a great example of how when you spend $10 at the auction, it might be worth a lot more. This time, the black and red lacquer box was hand-painted, was worth $300. That's a real bargain and a beautiful example, of course, of Russian craft. This next real bargain is from one of my favorite, of course, and all of you are my favorites, but one of my favorite video callers. She calls in with her friends from work, and we talk on video chats, and this particular piece was purchased for $4 at a thrift store in her town. She goes thrifting a lot, she makes her hauls, and she, in fact, bought this particular piece. So when I saw this piece, I'm thinking to myself, what would I look for? Because that's what you're all thinking, right? If you saw this piece in a thrift store, what would you look for? You'd look for the base. The base is beautiful, right? That backboard, right, of a beautiful material, a beautiful wood. You'd look for the intricacy of the actual relief sculptural design. You'd look for a characteristic subject matter, right? That means, what does it look like? And you look for that signature. In this particular case, you've got a signature too. Look for weight, right? Because in this case, it's bronze. The piece is bronze. It's by an artist named Russell Bowers. He's a very famous Native American artist who usually sculpts relief sculptures like this in, of course, his characteristic Native American subjects. So the story in this particular case is, of course, the Native American subject matter in the landscape of these two figures. It's signed, it's his original signature, and he usually puts them on these backboards. This piece is sitting there for $4 at the thrift store. It's an amazing find, a great real bargain, and in fact, what's it worth? You're gonna not believe it, $800. And it's sitting there in the thrift store, and she scooped it up for $4. I hope you've enjoyed these real bargains. There's more to come. Watch them all. And I hope you find your real bargain real soon.